Sergeant Preston of the Northwest Mounted Police with Yukon King, swiftest and strongest lead dog breaking the trail in the relentless pursuit of lawbreakers in the wild days of the Yukon. Back to the days of the gold rush as Sergeant Preston with his wonder dog Yukon King meets the challenge of the Yukon.
This is the Yukon, the territory patrolled by Sergeant Preston. The Klondike burning with a gold fever cooled only by winter's chilling breath that howled down from the Arctic wastes 8 months of each year. From the town of 40 Mile to the Alaskan border was 11 miles. But to a man without an experienced dog team, each step of the way could be a cruel trap, ending in an easy sleep from which he would never awaken. To a member of the Northwest Mounted Police like Sergeant Preston, as well as to the citizens he had sworn to protect, the most treasured possession was a dog team. And a great lead dog like Yukon King was beyond price. Though the weather was good, this was not a pleasant trip. Preston carried a writ in his pocket, a court order depriving a good friend, Eldridge Walker, of his dog team.
Hello! Hey, Billy boy! Billy!
Since the untimely death of his son in a snowslide, L. Walker had struggled to continue their freighting service between 40 Mile and Alaska as a legacy for his grandson, Billy.
Hi, Grandpa. How's Lori, Grandpa? Did she have any trouble on the trip to Circle City this time?
No, Billy, but I think Lori's made her last run for a while.
You mean she's ready to have her puppies?
Yeah, time's nigh, Billy. Now, you take Lori inside while I stake out the rest of the team out back, huh?
Sure thing, Grandpa. Come on, girl. There, Lori. Isn't that a swell bed I made for you while you were gone? I made it big. Because Grandpa said you probably have a big family. Next to Sergeant Preston, I bet Grandpa's the smartest man there is about dogs. See the bed I made for her, Grandpa? You think it's good enough?
That's real good, Billy.
And Lori seems to like it, too. Say, Grandpa, how long will we have to wait for pups?
Not for long, son. Not more than a day or so.
Oh, Lee, that's soon, huh? Too bad King can't be here when his new family comes, isn't it?
I wouldn't let that worry you, Barry. The sergeant will probably have King by here before long to visit with Lori and the pups. Billy?
Yes, Grandpa? Well, what is it, Grandpa?
Oh, it's nothing that won't wait, I guess. Oh, see if you can borrow some of that iron tonic from Mrs. Nestor. It'll be good for Lori.
Oh, sure.
I'm a sniveling coward, that's what I am, Lori. I've got to tell him I've lost the trading business, you dogs and all. I don't know how to tell him.
Wait outside, Stevens, and see that we're not disturbed while I have my little chat with Walker.
You sure he's back from Circle City, Mr. Hyde?
I saw him drive through town half an hour ago.
Okay, boss, but if he gives you any trouble...
Then we'll let the law handle it for me. How many times do I have to tell you, Ram? Gunplay is out. I'm going to take over Walker's freight company legal and proper.
Well, you're the doctor, but to my way of thinking...
I'll do all the thinking. All you have to do is obey orders.
Oh, Mr. Hyde.
Well, Walker, how about it? Your note is long overdue and my patience is exhausted.
At least wait till the pups come, Mr. Hyde. Why, a litter of Lori's pups fathered by Yukon King will be valuable. The sale of those pups will pay off my debts and give the company working capital besides.
Why should I be satisfied with the sale of some of those pups when all of them are practically mine already? Of course, if there's any money left over after my claim and costs are satisfied... It'll revert to you.
Why, you...
Ram Stevens is just outside the door, Walker. Don't be a fool.
This company will belong to the boys someday, and I'll die before I see him cheated out of it.
You always were one to let your emotions rule your mind. That's why I'm boss of this town. And you're broke. And just so you don't get any silly ideas, you might as well know that I got a writ of attachment from the court in Dawson. I was told your friend Preston would be on hand today to serve you, Walker. Should be a real happy reunion.
Hello, kid.
Hello.
Well,
if it isn't the junior member of the firm. What's in the bottle, Billy?
Iron tonic for Lori. Why are you here?
Business, son, business. Know how to take care of huskies, do you?
Better than some people, I guess.
Well, who knows? I might even have a job for you later, when I take over.
I'm gonna go in. Lori's waiting for this. Grandpa, what is it? Are you sick?
Oh, sick at heart, I guess. There's something I've got to tell you, son. Something I've put off for a long time, I guess. First, fetch me a cup of water, will you, Willa? Lost plumb full of cotton.
The old fool, stubborn as a mule.
Want to do it my way?
Not yet. We'll see how Preston makes out first. I can't afford trouble with the law.
Working for you as a bank guard is mighty dull to me.
Beats being on the wrong end of a rope. Come on. It's up to Preston now.
Grandpa, we can't just let him take Lori and everything away from us. I'll bet Sergeant Preston won't let him.
Well, there's nothing even the sergeant can do about it now. I was a fool to borrow that money from Hyde in the first place.
And I'll fix that old Hyde, betcha.
Billy! Now look at me. Now is as good a time as any for you to learn something. A gun never solves any problem, son. It only creates bigger ones.
Yes, Grandpa.
Remember always, two wrongs don't make a right, son.
Sorry, Grandpa. But Mr. Hyde shouldn't get the pups.
Oh, it isn't just the pups, Billy. Everything we own will have to be sold to satisfy our debt to Mr. Hyde. That's the law, son. Sergeant Preston will serve a writ of attachment today, according to Hyde.
Gee whiz. There must be some way.
Glad you run along and give Laura your tonic. I'll think of something.
You wait outside the bank. And keep an eye peeled for Preston.
All right.
Been, Hyde? Talking little Billy out of his birthright?
On your feet, Lance. I thought I told you to get out of town and stay out.
So you did. And paid me off.
So you thought. If you think you're going to get another cent out of me for taking that job with Walker and playing hob with his business, you're wrong.
It happens I did leave town. It also happens I was in court in Dawson when you got that order from the judge nailing Walker.
I paid you well to wreck Walker's freight company two accidents on the trail. That's where your interest ends.
Not quite, my friend. You see, I also found out from Ram Stevens what you want that freight company for. Neat way to run illegal gold out of the country. Isn't it, Mr. Hyde?
You'll lie in your teeth.
In that case, you won't mind if I speak to Sergeant Preston.
Keep your voice down. All right. What do you want?
My share, Hyde. Way I figure it, what with all the gold you can still run out this winter, you should net at least $50,000. I want half.
$25,000? I haven't that much personal cash on hand.
You have ways of getting it. I can make a mighty interesting speech to Sergeant Preston.
I've already paid you $5,000 for the job. Where's that?
It's safe. Over the border.
I'll give you another $10,000 and not a penny more, provided you leave here for good.
It's a deal.
But with Preston on the way, I can't take chances. You know where the old cabin is on the border trail?
Sure. When I worked for Walker, we used it sometimes for food cash.
I'll have Stevens there in an hour with the money.
I'll be there.
And don't try to cross me, boss.
As Preston and King progressed toward 40 Mile, they ran into heavy drifts across the trail, which cost them precious time.
At this very moment, L. Walker had suddenly made up his mind to do a foolish thing.
Come on, Lily. Grandpa is taking us on a trip across the border to Alaska.
Dog's all hitched up and ready to go, son. How about you and Laurie?
We're ready. But, Grandpa, won't Sergeant Preston be mad when he finds out what we've done?
Oh, I think he'll understand. I left a note for him on the table. We'll try to get out of the territory before he arrives here.
But you said before that two wrongs don't make a right. Isn't it wrong to run away like this?
Well, in a manner of speaking, no. You see, Clint Hyde can't take possession of the team until the writ is served. I'll see that the team is returned here after Laurie has her pups and I have sold them. Now, I think we'd better hurry.
Sure.
Come on, baby. Come on, sweetheart. That's all right. Now, take it easy. Come on. Come on, Laurie. Come on, baby. Hop in, Billy, and bundle up good.
But, Laurie, you're not hitching her up.
Heavens no, boss. She'll be in the sled with you. I put Kobuk in the lead.
But you said Kobuk wasn't ready to leave yet.
Well, she isn't really, but you work for me, I guess. There we go. Sit down. Take it easy.
All right, boys.
Billy and his grandfather fled down the border trail. Preston and King passed the signpost on the outskirts of Fort Lyon. Preston decided to make one last appeal to Banker Hyde before going to the Walkers' cabin.
Come in. Oh, Sergeant Preston.
I thought I'd drop in and have a little talk with you before serving L. Walker with a court order, Mr. Hyde.
There's been too much talk already, Sergeant. Now I want action. Where's the writ?
Right here. Legally, you're within your rights.
I don't need you to tell me that.
However, under the circumstances, I thought you might change your mind.
What circumstances?
Well, I suggested to headquarters that we buy Laurie's pups for the force. If the inspector agrees, the amount realized will more than cover Walker's debt to you.
Walker failed to pay off his note when it came due. I'm not interested in ifs and possibilities. I must insist you do your duty.
I'm talking to you as a man, Hyde, not as a policeman. A little more time means nothing to you. It means everything to L. Walker and his grandson.
You mean you refuse to serve this?
Of course not. But I have until midnight, according to law. And I intend to see that L. Walker gets every legal benefit he's entitled to.
You can't stall me. I'll serve it myself.
Now, just a minute. Sorry.
A while later, L. Walker drove his sled toward the abandoned cabin where he had a food cache, not knowing Stevens and Lance were there ahead of him.
Hey, Matt. Are you in there?
Waiting on you, Ram. Come on, hand over the money.
Not so fast, Lance. I'm keeping your blackmail money. You're getting this for blabbing on me to hide. I'm through with a lot of you.
No, Ram, no. I've got more money. I'll give that to you.
Whoa! What are we stopping here for, Grandpa?
Well, the team needs a rest, Billy, and so do I.
Grandpa, look! That's Matt Lance, the one who used to work for us. There's someone else with him.
Well, my old eyes aren't as good as they used to be, Billy.
Grandpa, the other man shot Matt!
Hup! All right, boys! Hike! Hike! Whoa! It's Matt Lance, all right, and he's hurt bad.
That's right, Walker. And so will you and the kid be if you make a wrong move.
Ram Stevens, I should have guessed.
You're a fine one to talk, running away from the law.
We're not either. Grandpa left a note for Sergeant Preston explaining the whole thing.
And whatever I was going to do, I'm staying right here till Preston comes along.
That's right, Walker. This is as far as you go. We're taking the team on from here. Now put Lance in the sled with that mutt.
Are you?
Go on!
Grandpa!
don't know. I don't feel so good. I feel kind of dizzy. Billy, what happened?
Ram Stevens. He hit you on the head and stole our team. He took Lori, too. Oh, Grandpa, what'll happen to Lori?
Now, now, Billy. You have to keep calm. My old head had only clear. He really must have cracked me one. Can't see so good.
Sorry, Grandpa. Before you jumped Ram, you said something about waiting for Sergeant Preston.
Sure, that's it, son. Preston's our only hope. He might be on the trail right now after reading the note. Give me a hand, Billy boy. The best place for us is inside the cabin, out of the weather.
Just lean on me, Grandpa.
Thank you, son.
I'll guide you. You think Sergeant Preston will catch our team in time to save Lori?
No, I don't know. I was a darn fool hoping he couldn't catch us before we crossed the border.
The fleeing Stevens was having his struggles. Time after time, the tiring team forced him to stop, and the border still lay ahead.
What's the matter with you dogs? Always stopping.
Water. I have none to spare. Here.
This sled rides hard.
All right. Tell me where the rest of your payoff money is hidden, and I'll dump you right here.
You lazy mutt. Okay, Huskies, line up. I said line up. Matt, wake up.
You know about dogs. These won't move.
Now what do I do?
You heard what I said. Answer me.
You got an inexperienced lead. Maybe the husky riding the sled bothers him. Jump her out.
Now we'll see if this dog puncher knows what he's talking about.
Go on, Husky!
Billy, where's your grandpa?
Inside the cabin, Sergeant. He's been hurt.
Let's go. Hell, what happened? Where's Lori and your team?
Billy and I caught Ram Stevens here as he was gunning down Matt Lance. Fellow who used to work for us.
Dog puncher?
That's right.
I remember him.
See, Lance was wounded. While Stevens was busy with Billy, I jumped him.
And Ram hit Grandpa on the head and got away with Lori and Lance, too.
What trail did Stevens take, El?
Billy says he was headed for the border. I wouldn't know. I went out like a light. Not doing too well yet.
That's right, Sergeant. They took the trail to Alaska. What do you think will happen to Lori?
Well, nothing if I can prevent it, Billy. How do you feel, Al?
Oh, much better. You go right ahead, Sergeant. I'll be all right.
Billy, will you come outside with me? I have some medicine on my sled for your grandfather. And stay here and take care of him, will you?
I'm under your orders, sir.
I'll be back as soon as possible, Al.
Lori and the team. Lori's the one we want. You know what I mean, Sergeant. Good luck.
Sure. Don't worry.
In a matter of minutes, Preston and King were back on the trail in pursuit of Stevens. When suddenly, for no apparent reason, King came to a dead stop.
Listen, King.
Did you find something?
Oh, so that's it.
Stevens must have dumped a dog out here and it wandered off. You think it's Laurie, huh?
Well, it could be.
I'm sorry, old fellow. The duty comes first. Oh, you'll take care of herself. After we arrest Stevens, we'll come back for her. Now, come on, let's not waste any more time.
In spite of his troubles, Stevens approached the haven of Alaska still safely ahead of his pursuer.
Whoa! Man, oh man. I never saw a sign look so good before. From now on, we take it easy. Go on, Huskies!
A few minutes later, feeling secure in United States territory, Stevens stopped to eat. He thought only of himself and didn't bother to unhitch the tired dogs or feed them. A short distance away, Preston arrived at the border.
was a good try, King, but our man got away. Nothing left to do now but to turn back and notify the American authorities by telegraph. Campfire. It's close by. If that's Stevens, he's certainly sure of himself. Here's what we'll do, King. Hide the team, cross the border ourselves. It is Stevens, you can't arrest him, but we can certainly make sure. Come on, let's go.
As they followed the tracks across the border, Preston had an idea. Stevens' team was in harness. Preston knew King could lead the dogs back across the border, and Stevens might give chase. It was worth a gamble.
As you go. You're under arrest in the name of the Crown.
You can't arrest me. We're in Alaska.
You were in Alaska.
So you tricked me. What's the charge?
I can answer that. I know enough to put him away for keep, Sergeant. And Clint Hyde, too.
I get the sled. Yeah, that'll do until I can get you to a doctor. It's only a flesh wound. Funky riding a sled made it seem much worse than it really is. King, we'll go after Laurie now. I know how anxious you and Billy are.
Please hurry, Sergeant. Please.
All right, Billy. Now, don't worry. Laurie is a good husky, and she'll instinctively take care of herself. All right?
All right.
Keep your chin up. El, think you'll be able to handle matters here till we get back?
You bet I can.
Fine. I don't think they'll give you any trouble. Come on, King. Let's go. You can see for yourself, King, the puppies are doing fine. Well, here comes Laurie. Your puppies are beautiful, Laurie. You and King should be proud parents.
Hello, El. Well, Sergeant.
Hello, King.
It's sure good to be home again.
I'll bet. How are you feeling?
Oh, much better, thanks.
Is Billy around?
Oh, he's out back seeing the Laurie and the pups. We built a special house for them.
Good.
Well, I suppose you'll be taking your prisoners back to Dawson.
Yes, the first thing in the morning. Meanwhile, they're safe behind bars here at the old headquarters building. Clint Hyde was a ringleader, head of a gang that's running illegal gold across the border. Why don't your express company as a front?
Well, then I won't have to worry about the mortgage anymore?
Well, I'm sorry about the mortgage, El, but it's still legal.
Oh, then Grandpa will have to give up Lori and the pups and everything?
No, Billy, that's what I stopped by to tell you. I received a message from Dawson this morning, and the Northwest Mounted Police want all of Lori's pups for the force. And they're willing to pay you a premium price for them, too. More than enough to clear off all your debts, El.
Yippee!
Well, it's up to King to train the pups after they're weaned. So you see, old fellow? A big job ahead of you, even though this case is closed.